Hi, my name is Roy. Today I'm going to draw my life. Psych! I'm gonna animate my life. Let's get started! So when my mom and dad got married, they, wait, that's way too far. Let's fast forward just a little bit. It was August 21st, 1991, and a new baby was born. His name was Roy. That's me. I was born in the Gupan City, Pangasinan in the Philippines. I was a dark, big-headed baby, and I was cute too. At least my parents said I was. When I was 2 years old, my parents and I moved across the world to America to a small town called Durham, North Carolina. My mom found a job there and it was basically where I grew up. When I was 4, my parents brought home a little baby. I was like, yo ma, yo pa, who dis? Why is he in my space? And they were like, this is your baby brother, Raymond. I was like, what? How'd you do that? And they're just like, it's a secret. When I first went to school, I was super shy and I always hated it. I always wanted to be around my parents because they made me feel so happy. One time in kindergarten, I had to pee so bad, but the teacher was teaching at the time, so I couldn't, and I was so shy to tell anyone, so I just eventually peed my pants. I eventually took ESL, or English as a second language, because my English was not too good. It took me a while to get rid of it, but I think I fixed my accent, which was really cool. And then I remember playing Legos with Raymond, and my parents came in with another baby. We were both like, ew, who is that disgusting thing? They were like, this is your baby brother, Russell. I was just like freaked out. I was like, how do you keep doing that? And I remember Raymond was like, yo, I thought that was a girl. Eventually, my brothers and I moved back to the Philippines when I was 8. My parents left us there while they got really situated financially in America. I remember I was horrified the first time I got there. Like, being 8 and knowing I'm going to be living there for a while, that was a huge deal. It took a really long time, but I grew to love the Philippines. Just basking in my culture and being around my relatives was just an awesome experience. It really taught me how to open up to others and appreciate things in life. And just as I became comfortable living in the Philippines, my dad came back and brought us back to America. I was like, what? I'm never gonna be comfortable in my life. Which is a good thing, because being uncomfortable is the best way to grow. When we got back to America, we saw this little baby hanging around. My mom was like, this is your baby sister, Ariel. I was like, how do you guys keep doing this? P.S. I was only 10 years old, so I really didn't know how they kept doing that. Anyways, I was in 5th grade at the time, and I remember going to school, and I just remember being extremely, extremely shy. Mainly because I got so used to the Filipino culture, and also I had a slight Filipino accent, which I thought everyone would judge me. It also sucked because everyone knew each other because they've been together all of elementary school, and there's just me, the new boy from the other country. I guess that really explains why I get quiet and shy sometimes. But it took me a while to break out of my shell. It wasn't until the 8th grade where I met some friends I could be comfortable around. Turns out they weren't the best of friends, but they really broke me out of my shell, which I am thankful for. That was also around the time my parents bought a video camera they would never use, so I would always use it and I would post it on YouTube. This was also the same time YouTube was created, 2005. That was also when I created Wasabi Productions. I didn't think much of it back then, but I'm so glad I made it. Then high school came along, and that's really when I started figuring out who I was. I remember my friend invited me to this Catholic retreat called Couples for Christ Youth, so I went. And to be honest, hands down, one of the best decisions I have ever made. I made a lot of lifelong friends there who are like brothers and sisters to me now. And being in that community, it really truly helped me figure out my faith, myself, and it fixed me up. With old friends gone and new friends made, I have never been happier in my life. I've gotten closer with my siblings, my parents, and it was just so awesome. After I graduated high school, I honestly did not know what I wanted to do. So I went to a community college and tried taking nursing classes. It turns out nursing is not my thing. So I transferred to North Carolina State University to pursue computer engineering. College was hard. I remember sleeping in libraries multiple times because I was up all night studying for some electrical circuit exam or whatever. It wasn't until I posted a video on YouTube called Call Me Maybe Parody. When that video went viral, I saw a change in perspective in my future. I figured I would just focus on YouTube because I was already good at it. So I changed my major to film studies. And guess what? I graduated. I don't know how, but I did. Plus, I did it for my mom because her dream is for all her kids to graduate college. So I did it, mom. I don't know how. I moved straight to Los Angeles right after college to see what I could do with this YouTube career. And Los Angeles really taught me a lot. Remember when I said being uncomfortable is what helps people grow? That's what LA did to me. It really solidified what I truly wanted in life. Well, honestly, I still don't know what I want, which is the greatest part. I left Wasabi Productions to create my own project called Guava Juice. Not sure where it's gonna go, but I know with constant hard work, it'll go somewhere eventually. Being successful doesn't mean having the most money or owning a nice car or house. I just believe it means being truly happy with yourself and doing your best to inspire those around you. Honestly, if it wasn't for everyone watching, I wouldn't even be here right now. So I really want to thank everyone for supporting me through my journey. If you're new to my journey, welcome! I can't wait to share what I have in store for you. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this Animate My Life. Stay humble. Remember, you are amazing, and I'll see you guys later. Bye!